Annurag at the ground of applause. He does multiple things for us. I don't know how he manages. Only woke up at 5 a.m. because he has a deadline to submit an article. So, kudos to you, Annurag. Morning, it's my honor and privilege to be here. First of all, I'd like to acknowledge my friends who are also stalwarts, pioneers, and in some way the creators of this domain. They're pioneers. So, I'd like to welcome somebody who really doesn't need any introduction to this community or in the business and the political community in India, Mr. Dilip Serian. Please give him a big round of applause. He's been an icon and a role model for a lot of us. I keep telling him when I grow up, I want to be like him. See, I'm trying hard, Dilip. We have our keynote speaker who comes specially from Singapore and he's from Ketchum. I would like to, I'm trying to get your name right, Mr. John Bailey. Welcome, Mr. Bailey. Please give Mr. Bailey a big round of applause. You know, 11 years back, we started exchanging media 17 and a half years back, almost 18 years back. And for the first 3.5 years of our life, we were trying to build a marketplace, B2B marketplace for buying and selling of media time and space, like the commerce for Ariba. So we were never intending to be a content player, we were not intending to be a media company. Me, Amit and Naval put our jobs to build a marketplace for media. And we failed at it because we were ahead of time. India is a very face-to-face, relationship-based society. Media is not standardized. We weren't smart enough, not that we are any smarter now. And then we exchanged for media, became the home page of everybody in marketing, advertising, media, communication. And about 11 years back, I met a gentleman, I don't know where he actually is, Mr. Singla. And I said, I want to do, you know, we exchange for media has become the platform it is today, and it has become the number one platform. But, you know, we, in the main platform, we tended to do more about media planning, buying, marketing. That's how we started. And he said, you don't do anything for the PR and COPCOM community. So I went and saw Dilip, and then I met Prema, I met Ashwini, met Madan, met 4 or 5 people and said, we want to do this. And we put together the first IPRCCA. Ashwini contributed tremendously to that. He was the jury chair, he made calls, and he really spent time. So I really want to thank you, Ashwini. A gratitude is due to you, and please give Ashwini a big round of applause. So really, you know, as the day progresses, you'll see that we have a full house. It's already almost a full house. Now, you're COPCOM and PR professionals. I don't have to tell you what's happening in this domain. Now, I spend most of my time in business world because I still have a long way to go there, but maybe another 6 months and we'll build what we set out to. We got somewhere, but it's a company that I acquired, and you know, I've lost more hair trying to change it, but we're on our way. But I want to outline 5 things, according to me, which in some way are transforming the corporate communication and PR landscape. First is, for the first time I see, I talk to a lot of PR professionals, they call, I'm mostly polite to all of them, except when people call and insist on talking, I take calls in that second, and some people call me by my first name, I tell them I don't know you long enough, and some ask me if I show up for a press conference, I tell them if they paid me $10 million, maybe yes, but mostly I'm polite. But, you know, I can say for the first time I see a lot of people have a better business orientation than when I started 18 years back. I have to acknowledge that. Second, they understand the business environment much better. Third, they understand the marketing and business objectives much better. And this is because of my interaction with people across the value chain. I remember 7 years back at a similar conference, I talked about the, and Dilip was on that panel, or, I mean, he spoke, what if media agencies who buy most of the media take over the PR function? But that hasn't happened, so kudos to you. But it's still a threat. In mid-sized and smaller media agencies, they still look at PR because they have the clout to buy media. And when you talk to governments and political institutions, their media buying and PR is intertwined. So how do the media agencies, the PR agency, the COPCOM professionals deal with it? Second, the biggest challenge is which we in the media face, but you as professional face, is the challenge of fake news. We are at the receiving end of that. We are not the creators of fake news. Politicians and vested groups create fake news. How do you deal with that? Third is the increasing number of content platforms. Today there may be an insignificant story on some platform that you've never heard of, which has come up 3 days back, sponsored by somebody, and suddenly spreads like fire, wildfire. So how do you keep track of the number of media that are growing? Of course, you use technology, but at the end of the day, the response has to be human. There has to be a strategy around it. Fourth is, you know, our business of, even as a media business, dare I say, is becoming the business of content marketing. Today when I talk to clients, I talk to our advertisers, I talk to our subject, everybody in some way talks of content marketing. And you know, as an editorial person, I don't like that, because that means native advertising. That means, so how does a PR professional become a content marketing professional? How does a Copcom professional align himself or herself to understanding the trends in content? The last, you know, earlier you would have a crisis once in 3 months, once in a year. Today, what I call crisis 360 degree. We are, it's not the name of a PR firm, it could be, but today most professionals deal with, and crisis may be the strong word, but this, you deal with a complaint, you deal with an issue, literally 24/7. And again, the technology can detect them, monitoring can detect them, but they need a human response. How do you make sure you are geared up as a client, as a PR agency, to deal with them? My last and probably good point. I've seen in lots of corporates, the CMO become the CEO. We haven't done research, but maybe you should commission, Dilip may know, Ashwin may know. How many head of communications have gone on to become CEOs? Not many. Why not? Because, so I would challenge you, encourage you to think like a CEO. And I keep saying CEO is nobody. He's the chief everything officer. You've got to have an appreciation. You've got to have talent. So these are the things that I'd like to outline. And today we have a fantastic lineup of speakers. And you'll hear them. In the evening we have our awards. And I must say this. You know, Ashwini is there, he was in the first awards. Subsequently, I've not even sat through juries, I've not involved. As I said, I spent 99% of my time in business. You know, there are too many awards happening. What is the differentiator between one award and another award? I can say, looking in each one of your eyes and put a hand over my heart, and the jury will vouch for it, forget me and my editorial colleagues, that these are the most honest, robust, process-driven awards. Can they be better? Everything can be better. But when you get an award tonight, you know that it has come through a peer recognition from professionals who understand this domain and does a three-tiered process. So these are very honest, credible. And I think that separates the boys from men, so to say, or the girls from ladies, right? Not to be chauvinist, right? So when you get the awards tonight, you know that they have been done in an absolutely process-driven manner. We are only custodians of the brand and the process. We have no impact on the awards. I also want to make some announcement. This is a domain that we've done, but we've not focused on it. I think the potential in this domain, and to segment and sub-segment, and to dive into this domain is huge. I want to announce three new initiatives. We do an Impact Digital Power 100. We do an Impact top 50 women list every year in March. From early next year, we launch a PR 100 for the top professionals in the PR industry, and Copcom 100, the top 100 professionals in the Copcom domain. We'll also launch a 30 under 30 young list, because 40 under 40 is no longer young, right? I know people like me and Dilip may think, you know, that we are still young, and we are in some way. But really, these are three initiatives that, so we will do much more in this community, editorially, because we tend to be a little more broader. And as exchange from India, we bring CEOs, CMOs, people beyond PR to this domain. Because if there's a value in PR, people reading about PR people, but I think the value in the whole ecosystem engaging with your community and our community is much more important. Journalists. Today at the conference, you'll see more journalists than you see at any PR conference, you know. So I just wanted to outline this. Naval also asked me to talk about three new initiatives this year, which have been ongoing, but they are bigger, better. Priyanka and Karan have put together, Priyanka on the edit side and the curation side, and Karan on the business side. These are two people. Priyanka also does our exchange for media news broadcast awards. I remember when we started this again 11 years back, a lot of people said to me, why are you awarding news anchors? What do they do good? What do broadcasters do? I think everyone has a space. So they have again become the number one recognition in this domain. Again, we do everything through a jury process. So we have the jury on the 30th Jan and the 16th Feb is our INBA, the exchange for media news. This year our jury is about 20 people. The chairperson of the jury is Dr. Kiran Kani, and there are 11 editors on the jury who are not news TV editors. There are three MDs, there are two media planning CEOs, there are two former IMD ministers, Mr. Manish Tiwari is on the jury, Mr. Arif Mohammed Khan is on the jury. So we have a very, I mean, this year we've kind of taken the jury to another level. And again, 2 years back, we started the Exchange for Media Digital Outlook with the Dentsu Ages Network, because for the last 14 years with Madison, we do a pitch Madison Advertising Outlook. So on the 16th of Jan in Bombay, we have the Dentsu Ages Network Exchange for Media Digital Outlook 2019, where we forecast the trends. So while we do it for pitch, for the advertising marketing, from next year we'll start to do a PR outlook, where we look at the, you know, outlook for that domain, including numbers, qualitative aspect. So I just want to tell you that we haven't done these three things in the past. We'll start doing, and there'll be a lot of data inputs inside. Last but not the least, our success and our domain platforms are only about engagement. I don't want to talk about the traffic or how successful Exchange for Media is, but I can tell you it's like having 500 seats in the Lok Sabha every election. I wish, and I'm sure business world will get there in terms of that dominance. But I just want to say that Exchange for Media is where it is because of the involvement and the engagement of every one of you. Editorially, we don't do enough in the PR popcorn domain. We currently continue to head our business side on the PR domain. We'll be seeing it as a subdomain, which is very important. But we'll be bringing in two more editorial colleagues on that. At some stage, we'll introduce you to them. And we are bringing domain experts, people who have been in the COPCOM PR domain, they understand. So when they talk to you, it is a nuanced conversation. You know, you get something from them while they get something from you. So I just wanted to take this opportunity to share this. I'm here, one of the few events I'll be here all day, and I look forward to interactions, and I look forward to learning from all the speakers and the stalwarts in the room and all the young people, because the young professionals have more hunger, more guts, more curiosity, and dare I say more energy to be able to create something new. So I look forward to our interaction with you, and I wish you a day of learning and connections. Thank you.